Hi, this is Sumit from India. First of all, thanks a lot to my viewers that you have loved so much to our previous videos. Thank you for your support. In our previous videos, you must have seen that we have dedicated our channel to give the magic and the feel of hi-fi for all. So that is why Dhwani has decided to change its name into Hi-Fi for All. If you can remember my previous video, we had discussed that from next episode onwards, we will talk regarding the source, regarding the amplification system, speakers, and various aspects for hi-fi to get the magic, to get the bliss of hi-fi. So now, in this episode, we have started to discuss source, analog source. Analog source will be divided into three parts, because in this source you'll be having reel-to-reel tapes, cassette tape, and vinyl records. So this is the first episode. In this episode we'll discuss about reel-to-reel tapes. You must be thinking right now that what this guy is doing. He has put us into the time machine and we are going back in 1950s. Why? You are right, my dear friend. Reel-to-reel tapes, it started its journey way back in early 90s. And it is being familiar and taken as the best recording media ever into the recording studios, majorly by three companies. First of all, two Studerivox, second is Ampex, third is Atari. Majorly these three companies. Now, why reel-to-reel tapes? Where the entire world is talking about digital, is analog good? And that to be reel-to-reel tape? Yes, my dear friends, this is the best format ever. Best format, absolutely the gold standard to record the audio as well as to reproduce the audio. It comes generally in four types: half-inch tape, quarter-inch tape, one-inch tape, and two-inch tape. This 1-inch and 2-inch, it's generally used to use inside the studio as a professional media for recording. But quarter-inch and half-inch, it is for domestic use. But mainly 10-inch reel of quarter-inch. All tapes generally 30 microns thick. It's all magnetic tapes, majorly produced by German companies called Agfa, as well as BASP. You can get it from Sony, you can get it from TDK, you can get it from Maxwell. So there are many companies. It's still available actually. But guys, this format is very, very costly. Because one 10-inch reel for studio is costing around $250 to $400. That much costly it is. And it serves a recording purpose around for 30 minutes at the speed of 50 frames per second. That means 15 inch per seconds. Very fast, yes it is. That's the professional recording speed. Yes. But at home, generally playback speed is 3 3/4 inches per second. And you'll be getting a quarter inch and a half inch tape. In the market, there are many sources from where you can get pre-recorded tapes. Pre-recorded tapes, that to be reel to reel? How? Yes, my dear friend. Almost all the recording companies, they sell the copy of the actual master copy, which is pre-recorded, and it is available in many websites. You can buy it from there. It's not economical, it's costly. It's costing around $150 per reel, but it's a marvel. It's gold. You can feel the studio at your home. Instrument. Yes, guessed it right. Only this company called Tascam still making reel to reel tape player as well as recorder for home, 8-track. It is inbuilt, with inbuilt amplifier or without inbuilt amplifier. So you need to buy a set of speakers and you are ready to go. But my dear friend, certainly it is costly. This tape deck is costly. It's not economical. What about vintage? Oh yes, you can get a huge range of vintage reel-to-reel decks. You name it. National, Panasonic, Technics, Sony, Akai, Telefunken, many Ampex, Revox, Studer Revox, many company was making those marvels, and it's still available in the vintage market. Are they really good? They're fantastic. But it's only one problem. To get the spares, it's really a very tough call. And moreover, to get a skilled mechanic for them, it's a problem. So if you consider this format, then certainly you need to think about the pros and cons. So here comes the pros. First, a fabulous sounding media. Completely gold standard. No one can match it. Second, it doesn't degrade so fast. Third, you can feel the studio at your home. Fourth, if you talk about cost, it may sound to you, yes, it is costly, but I must say that it is cost effective, because a live concert is give you around 120 dB, per ticket cost is very high. But here you can feel the live concert at your own doorstep with only $150 per reel. Cons. Costly. The system is costly. The spool itself, it's costly for many people. Third, the mechanics as well as the spares are really a problem for reel to reel. If anybody is having reel to reel still at your home, maybe at your storeroom or a junkyard, please take it out. Go to a mechanic, refurbish it. You can feel the magic, trust me. Now here comes a sample for you. And my dear friend, this sample I have collected, which has been recorded in ambience sounding. It is not directly recorded. The way we hear the music, absolutely in that way. So, long live analog format, long live reel to reel. Here's the clip for you. I know what you're thinking. A fantastic sounding, sexy machine, isn't it? Yes, it is. It is Tascam STR8. Fantastic sounding machine. So guys, the first episode of Analog Source is over now. Wait for the second episode, and where we'll discuss regarding the cassette tape. By then, bye-bye.